Welcome to part one of this Local 47 Roundtable. Today we are hearing from Local 47 members working for Outside Construction.
Rich Corral, Traffic Control Tech.
Dean Owens, Journeyman Lineman.
Joe Leon, Journeyman Lineman.
Daniel Vargas, Infrastructure Tech.
Luis Gonzalez, Infrastructure Tech.
The purpose of this discussion is to talk about our struggles and how we get through them, what to do, who to talk to, and how to stay safe.
What's up, fellas? My name is Joe Leon, and I'm a journeyman lineman. My day-to-day struggles, and I would say more of a challenge, is keeping that momentum going, staying competitive, and finishing strong every day. And especially with our younger generation.
The biggest thing too, and for us, and I'm a journeyman also, is the teaching. They come to us not knowing, and then we have to establish an environment where they can learn from, and that's difficult because when we show up, we organize everything. We're prepared to go out, but where we're going and what we're doing, the younger generation still doesn't know. But the cutoff is there's an expectation that they should know, and that's trade wide for us. So I would say that goes hand in hand. You can't have momentum for the next guy. You have to keep it for yourself.
It's contagious when they see a guy like Hugh, who's been around the trade for a lot of years, moving, framing poles, putting up lines, getting the bucket, getting the job done. And when a young guy sees that, he should be just as fast as you or side by side with you. And that's, I think, what you're probably saying right now is consistency and getting the guys up to par with what you're supposed to do out there.
And mostly, too, I find myself with that struggle, and just with myself, is that persistence. That persistence, because you're gonna finish strong at the end of the day, but then the next day, you gotta be better than the day before. And as individual myself, that's how I maintain the momentum for me, is making sure that I'm not failing my apprentice or that young journeyman lineman the next day. I gotta show up and do my best. And you gotta lead by example. And we're so blessed to be in this trade. We are, and for all the help that we have, yeah, from the traffic guys to the infrastructure fellas, And then the great journeyman linemen, you know, that take pride in what we do.
So how do you motivate these new guys, new generation?
So the way you motivate them, you got to show them, right? In order to show them, like, you got to step in there and know what you're doing. You got to be able to lead by example, right? So you can't change the whole trade at once, right? So it's great to be on the crew with four guys, right? And the way you change them is you show them to appreciate, right? And you show them what it is to be determined, right? And with that determination, I've been taught as an outside construction lineman, that determination, and you become stubborn. And that's consistency. You know, you keep them consistent. You do that on a day by day and take it one day at a time. And it's good to have that apprentice with you day in, day out, hopefully for a whole year, you know, and you teach them. You just teach them, you coach them. You make sure that the guy is learning and you explain to them. Make sure you invest your time, because what I do tell these kids is, and even the young journeyman linemen, that if I take my time to teach you, then I can walk away from this relationship knowing that if you fail, then you failed yourself.
Exactly.
You know, and that's how I do it. And I make sure. And it, believe me, it took a lot of years to be able to express the way I exercise and go about my daily base. Like, it did. And it took wanting to do what's right. You gotta be able to do what's right. And for the trade, you know, it's not about yourself sometimes. It's about the trade and your family and moving this whole thing forward. You gotta be willing to do that to maintain success, yeah, in our trade.
Hey guys, I'm Richard Corral, Traffic Control Tech. My job is to get my truck ready, make sure I have all the right equipment, and to go out into the field with either the line side, with the journeyman lineman, with the linemen, and or with the tree guys, or underground, to get the lanes taken for you guys so you guys can get into the work zone safely when it's time to work. And while you guys are working, my job is to keep you guys safe, the residents safe, the traffic that's flowing through, keep them flowing. You know, it's a big responsibility being out there taking care of you guys and keeping you guys safe as well as us. I think the biggest thing is, you know, you got guys that are new to the trade and, you know, just ain't taking it to heart like I do. A lot of guys take the trade as just dropping cones and, you know, you're collecting paychecks. And I think that's my biggest problem right now is, man, just these guys just not taking their job serious is a big part of something that I want to fix, you know.
How do we change that? Like, how do we help these younger guys, not even the younger guys, just the guys on site, stay focused and make sure that they're doing such? Because we depend on you guys to watch as we're on the lines and you know, moving wire, letting wire down, crossing, you know, over the freeways and you know, you see the obstacles out there.
Yeah.
That was my biggest question is, do you feel like it's generational? Is it an age group? Or is it just as a whole getting the focus and gaining the integrity and taking it as being humbled and honored to have the position they have?
Yeah, it's something that you don't learn overnight, just like a journeyman lineman. You don't become a journeyman lineman or an infrastructure tech overnight. And it takes time, but you got to study. Just like you got to study your table of contents in your book, and you gotta understand the specs, the speed limits, the lengths of tapers, the buffer lengths. You gotta know all that so there's a nice transition depending on the speed limit, but it all starts with me. It starts with a guy like me and like my brothers that have been around for a long time to let these guys know, get them scared. Let them understand that this job is not just dropping cones and hanging out on your phone and collecting a paycheck. It's lives are at stake right here, you know, including ours. You know, it starts with me, you know, being able to coach them up and understand the safety of it all and how serious it is and how big of a responsibility that we have out there, you know, in the field, you know.
So as leaders, you know, all of us, we got to lead by example.
100%.
You know, and I believe that that's where it starts. You got to lead by example, teach these guys to, no matter what you're doing, you know, on the infrastructure side or the traffic techs or even us as journeyman linemen, that's a huge disconnect right now is leading by example and showing these guys what's right. And it starts off with one guy at a time.
Yeah, 100%.
Hey guys, I'm Luis Gonzalez. I'm an infrastructure tech, and my job consists of a lot of different things. I can be anywhere from, you know, blowing air through the conduits to put lines in, so you guys can come in and put your cable through our conduits, and or I can also just be breaking out concrete, preparing to fix some sidewalk. It's all over the place, but I feel like my tasks are as much of a struggle as much as it is to growing into a person of leadership. You know, I'm not a foreman yet, but over the years I have been taking my job a lot more seriously than when I first started. And it's a struggle to transition from just showing up to work and now showing up and being a person of leadership and taking initiative, being more responsible. And, you know, just trying to put myself out there as a different growing person. And it's hard to change how people have viewed you in the past, how, you know, because people change, people grow. And you know, it could be hard to just be someone more than you once were. And people sometimes don't see that. And it takes time. It takes time. And you got to be persistent. You got to show that you're moving forward and you always will be.
How did you overcome the obstacles over the years, and what were the struggles that you had to overcome in order to make you a better leader, it sounds like?
More than anything was the mentors that I worked with, the people that were teaching me, showing me, you know, how to maneuver around the trade and, you know, just making myself seem like a better person and will actually be a better person just for people to see it, you know? That was a huge key, and it still is to this day, watching closely the way people work and their attitude. Attitude is very contagious, and something that recently I think about when I'm at work is what would, if my family were to be watching me work, like would they be proud of me? Would they be embarrassed? You know, and I kind of live by that, and that helps me a lot on my day-to-day work.
How can you motivate the next guy to go through the same transition that you did to start recognizing your trade is important more than yourself?
Well, just by showing them something similar to what I live by, to, you know, at the end of the day, if you work, you will be compensated by, you know, staying on the job. And if you don't, you know, you don't pull your weight, you will be not let go, but, you know, kind of pushed aside and stuff like that. And you know, everybody's family, you can't, but the way you work is, you're a representation of how you feel for your family. You know, you're there to provide for them. You're there to be a solid worker.
That's good.
And it won't show if you're not there.
It's a reputation. You gotta, you know, and it follows you, especially if you're gonna be in the trade for a lot of years. And if you're, if anything goes across the board again, you know, your reputation over the years, you know, you get to meet gentlemen like these guys and you guys, and you know, phone call away 10 years later, you know, like, hey, can you use me? Like, oh, come on down, boom. So yeah, it's very, very important to keep a good reputation and work hard.
Yeah, of course.
Goes a part way. But on the other note, like, I know that your work is very dangerous as well. I know the scaffold, I've been around it, and you guys got to bring your trenching, you know, and you're in there putting the conduit in, and being in underground, you know, it's very dangerous. So how important is your safety to you being safe and getting all your guys in and out of there and home safe?
Oh, definitely. Myself as a person of maybe a leadership role in my crew, always watch out for safety, always watch out for trench depths, soil types and stuff like that. Make sure we have the proper equipment to work safely, be working in there. You know, sometimes, you know, you catch yourself doing something that seems sketchy and you got to stop it then and there without fear of, you know, repercussion, because you know how sometimes like, oh, well, you just do it and stuff like that. And then it shouldn't be that way.
Trying to get the job done. That's when, you know, people get hurt out there, right?
I think someone's in the trench and it doesn't look like they should be in there, you know, come out, take a look, you know, inspect the soil real quick. Does it look like it's caving in?
Yeah.
You know, just walk around and make sure. If we do our own traffic control, make sure nothing's close to where the lane is closed, you know, keep everything clear, have a clear path, or something simple as a walkway. Sometimes the dirt is too close to the trench. Something so simple, you step on a rock and roll your ankle, and now you're, you know, 8 feet down the trench head first, you know, something simple as just keeping a clean, tidy workspace. And it doesn't take long. It takes just a few seconds to, you know, move the dirt or just stay organized. That's a big key. Stay organized and stay on top of, you know, just be vigilant the whole time.
Yeah. Now, that's great to see that your hard work paid off. Yeah, that's great. You work hard now and then it's easier at the end. Or some guys take that route the opposite way. It's like they want it to be easy and then hard later, but it doesn't work out that way. Like, you want to teach that on the front end. So that's great.
So basically that the issue is the same way across the board for pretty much the whole industry, infrastructure, traffic, power lines, trees. It's the same goal, getting these guys to have pride in their work and to get home safe to their families and learn the trade to be successful. And yeah, it starts with us, right?
Sometimes you have to humble a guy though and make sure that they remember it's an honor to have a union. It's an honor to be a part of this brotherhood. And that's something that's lost. We don't speak enough to the younger, or even, it's not even age-based. So when we speak about younger, it's just new to our trade and new to our industry. But those individuals haven't been honored or know even that it's an honor to exist the way we do, because for so long, the workforce required bodies that we didn't teach about brotherhood. We didn't teach about integrity with each other and to be each other's keeper, right? Like, to be your brother's keeper is big, but it's almost a forgotten art because it's not taught. We don't show up to look out for the next guy. It's selfish now. Everybody shows up for themselves. And that's, sometimes you have to humble guys and remind them. And sometimes that might mean that you relocate them somewhere else. If they're not working and they don't, you don't feel like they're family with you, sometimes they got to go somewhere else to find their spot, to fit in and be humbled and remember that it is a brotherhood. Because that's the biggest ticket, right? Everybody here is a brotherhood. We're here for each other, not just for ourselves. Sure, we bless our families, but we can't bless our families without you and you and you, and me and you. Yeah. Everybody here pays into each other's families.
Thanks for listening to part one of this Local 47 Roundtable. Tune in to hear the remainder of this discussion in part two.